Did you press start?
No, I just did press start. Is it okay that your voice saying, do you need me to press start, is in there?
For sure.
Yeah, okay. Alright. Here we go. Well, now I'm doing this left-handed, and I'm right dominant in terms of my handedness, but I did have the idea that I wanted to make a yellow painting today, and I had originally intended that I would talk about, you see, yesterday I put some yellow on a painting and then I covered it over with white. Basically erased it.
Mm-hmm.
And I was feeling unhappy in what felt like a fundamental way with the very idea of the project.
Right.
And I was starting to wonder whether I had an idea. Or that is to say, an idea that was an idea capable of meaningful development.
Mm-hmm.
You know how some ideas are just sort of clever notions, and some ideas are rich and meaningful.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, that might be not an inherent property of the idea, but rather a matter of one's approach to something, right?
Yeah.
Anyway, I was just going to have a blank yellow field and talk about how disappointing it can be to
think of an idea and have it not be fecund.
Yeah. Or to feel that the idea that you're working on is not... Fecund is a good word. Yeah. Not productive. Not generative.
Not bearing fruit.
Right. Not bearing fruit. Right. Or barren.
Right.
You know, I mean, somehow intrinsically barren. Anyway, that was going to be my video for the day. I was thinking, though, that maybe it would be the case that I've said I'm going to do this for a month, so I would just keep doing it, but maybe I would develop in some unforeseen direction, and I would never end up making any of these paintings, right?
Right.
But then I had this idea, because I've been thinking a lot about the supports for a picture and the picture itself, you know? Mm-hmm. Like, say, in this instance, the canvas and the paint. And trying to come up with a novel, a different way of approaching support as a part of painting. And I kind of had an idea. Which was that I could make a giant painting and cut it into pieces. Because, you know, I'm trying to think of a kind of equivalent in terms of the painting's picture plane to the kind of space that you see in a cell phone, where you can almost imagine that there's this endlessly extending plane behind the surface of the phone that you can swipe endlessly in any direction.
Yeah.
You know? Which seems like a very contemporary way of thinking about a picture surface. You know, in the an older way of thinking about a picture surface would be as a window, you know? A bounded area that gives you access to some space you can demarcate, you know?
Right.
Anyway. It probably would take longer than to explain that, or longer for me to think about the proper explanation than we have today. But the point is, I reinvested in the whole idea, and it no longer seemed hopeless anymore.